Hey everyone, just want to give you an update on what happened yesterday. I was getting onto the interstate, and just as I gave it some throttle to get on the interstate, I had a loud boom, and it was a loud explosion, and looked in the rearview mirror and saw black smoke bellowing out, and something didn't sound right, so I pulled off to the side of the road immediately. Started checking around, and turns out that the intercooler, the upper intercooler pipe, blew off. This actually completely blew off, blew up and out of the way, and broke this piece right here. There's a clip that goes around here. I have the clip, but the section here chipped out, blew this thing completely off, and I lost boost. So I have a new one on order from Ford, just as a temporary fix, but I also will be getting the H&S intercooler pipe, because this bottom section is plastic, this upper section is plastic, and they're most commonly known to blow out. Actually, they're more commonly to blow out down here on this lower plastic piece. So if you, and it actually happens on totally stock motors after about 30 to 40,000 miles. And I just so happen to have 37,500 miles on this truck at 4 years old, and it just couldn't take it anymore. And I'm running higher than normal boost because of the tuner. So normal boost maxes out around 25 pounds. I'm maxing out around 35 pounds of boost, with, the factory setup. I still have the EGR cooler on here. I haven't gotten around to deleting that yet. I do have the crankcase ventilation delete kit, bypass kit. I have the intercooler, EGR cooler delete kit that I still have to do. But right now, like I said, this thing left me stuck on the side of the road. I was able to drive it and get it back home with no boost, zero boost. It was just, the section was just removed, and I drove home with it at zero boost. I still was able to do about 50 miles an hour in limp mode, so it wasn't too bad. But anyway, just wanted to give you guys an update and let you know that it's pretty essential, if you have one of these 11 to 15 6.7s, that you need to completely delete the factory setup and put some aftermarket brand on there. Like I said, I'm going with H&S because I've been using them for years and I trust them, and they make great equipment. So I'm going with the H&S. I haven't decided if I'm going with the OEM version, which just clips onto here, or if I'm going with their delete version, which actually deletes this throttle body. This is a mechanical throttle body, electromechanical throttle body. So once you do that, you have to have the delete tune, which I do have, but I'm not sure if I may be converting this truck back to stock for emissions purposes, because I may be going over the road doing hot shotting and need to pass DOT inspections. So I would have to have this back to stock mode. So I haven't decided yet, but anyway, just want to give you guys an update. I do have a couple video clips of what it looks like blowing off coming up at the end of this video. So just stay tuned, keep watching, and you'll see what it looks like and sounds like when the pipe blows off. Like I said, if you're under full boost like I was, it's going to go boom, and you're going to think your engine exploded, but it's just that pipe coming apart, and you will be able to limp home in limp mode. So anyway, stay tuned, and thanks for watching.